Hi, I'm Paul Nuttall of What Digital Camera Magazine. We're here at Nikon headquarters with James Banfield, and he's going to talk us through some of the key features of the new Nikon D4.
Thank you. Well, this is the new Nikon D4. It's the replacement for the D3S, and it has over 45 new features. The first feature I should really mention is the sensor. The D3S was, and the D3 before it, was renowned for its incredible sensor technology and certainly its low light capability. So with the D4, what we've really worked on is being able to increase the resolution. So it's gone up from 12 to 16.2, and the ISO range has also gone up. So previously we were at 102,400 ISO equivalents, we're now at 204,800 ISO equivalents. The D4 is also our first DSLR to introduce the new X-Speed 3 processing architecture. What this allows the camera to do is truly amazing. The processing speed is much faster, and this in the background has a real positive impact on every aspect of the camera, from its HD recording to its incredibly smooth gradation in its stills imagery, to the ability to process RAW and JPEG files really quickly. And transfer that information to the card. We have a new metering system in the D4. On the D3, it was a 1,005 pixel RGB sensor that could see in full color in 3D. This now has an astonishing 91,000 pixel RGB sensor that again can see in 3D and full color. Now, where this makes the impact is because it's able to track the subject as it moves around the scene, because it can see in color and it's got that resolution. And although we had face detection in D3, with an increase in resolution, the face detection is able to detect smaller faces within the scene and able to meter more accurately because of that. On top of this, the autofocus has been dramatically improved. We've still got the same Multicam 3500FX, which is tried, trusted and loved by the sports photographers around the world, but we've improved its capability further. So what this actually means is that this can now shoot an incredibly low light, and it can also now focus in the low light. So it's -2 EV, which is the equivalent of moonlight, and the camera is able to focus within such low light levels, which means it can track. So you've got the capability of shooting still images and also fast action in incredibly low light. This has an bigger importance, though, for a lot of people that are traveling with this type of camera, where we anticipate that they will use it, is teleconverters, which you normally lose a stop and a half, two stops of light. They can actually really now be used with the D4, and you get, for virtually all of the combinations, all 51 points, and it's only the F4 range or above where you're using 2x or the 1.7 where you really start to see any infringement. So this camera can actually focus with lenses that are even at F8, which again, for sports photographers, means they could take a 2-400 F4 and a 2x converter and travel around the world and have an 800mm F8 lens without the weight and baggage. So other features on the D4 that we've spent a lot of time and attention on are the ergonomics. So we have a camera that you can shoot in the dark with, we have a camera that you can focus in the dark with, and now we have a camera that you can use in the dark. So one of the things that we've listened to for the photographers is there's an option where you can have back illuminated buttons, so you can quickly and easily move your way around the camera. We also listened to photographers that were telling us that they wanted changes to the button layout in the back. So there's a new AF toggle switch, which is here and here, and the AF buttons are almost perfectly matched, so that if you're using it in landscape or portrait, the actual button layout and the feel of the camera is very, very, very similar. The other thing as well that I'm really excited about is that we are the first manufacturer to introduce the brand new XQD card. Now, this was a card that was announced by the Compact Flash Association just before Christmas. And XQD allows some incredible write speeds for shooting RAW or JPEG. So photographers for the first time are going to be breaking that 100 frames in a continuous burst in RAW, and JPEG you're approaching now 200 frames. This is also perfect for recording video as well, which requires very fast write speeds to ensure you get the ultimate high quality video at the end.